Hi, welcome to another edition of the Pop Music Almanac Solid Gold Scrapbook. I'm Dick Bartley with a profile of one of the fun pop rock groups of the 60s, Jan and Dean.
The greatest hits, Solid Gold Scrapbook.
Dean Torrence was born on March the 10th, 1941. He and Jan Barry first began singing together at Emerson Junior High School in L.A. back in the mid-50s. Before Jan and Dean were through, they had half a dozen unforgettable top 10 hits to their credit. Jenny Lee, Jan and Dean's first big hit from 1958 in the scrapbook. Dean Torrence reflects on the fact that the Jan and Dean oldies have remained popular over nearly three decades of time.
The tunes are all fairly simple. Luckily for us, we understood how important it was to technically make them sound as good as you could. And They do come from a certain era that was thought of as pretty much a lot of fun. So maybe all those elements thrown in with some other things have made them endure. But I'm just happy they are. You know, I'm thrilled.
She cannot speak very well. Everybody knows that, but to me she sure looks well in her baby clothes. I ask her if her love is true, and she only goes,
yeah.
That, which means to say she loves me.
Ba 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 ba
Dan and Dean on the Solid Gold Scrapbook. Herb Alpert and Lou Adler, two legendary names in the California music business, produced and promoted that one, Baby Talk, on the Door label in 1959. By 1961, Jan and Dean had struck again with an updated version of the old piano duet, Heart and Soul.
I fell in love with you, heart and soul, the way a fool would do madly, because you held me tight and stole a kiss in the night. Heart and soul, I begged to be adored, lost control, and tumbled overboard gladly. That magic night we kissed there in the moonlight. But your lips were thrilling, much too thrilling. Never before were mine so strangely willing. But now I see what one embrace can do. Look at me, it's got me loving you madly. That little kiss you stole held all my heart and soul. Pop 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 dip 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 da 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 dun dun da ding di ding di dong. Pop 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 dip 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 pop 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 dip 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 dip. Oh, but your lips were thrilling. Thrilling. Never before were mine so strangely willing. Yeah, but now I see what one embrace can do. Look at me, it's got me loving you madly. That little kiss you stole fell on my heart and soul.
Jan and Dean, Heart and Soul in the Scrapbook. A big part of Jan and Dean's presentation, both on record and in live concerts, was the mixture of comedy and music.
I guess it was pretty much from our personalities. We definitely didn't plan on doing that or have it be a conscious effort in doing comedy. We just always had a sense of humor about most everything. And well, gosh, when we started at 17, 18, in the 50s and early 60s, everything was pretty silly. You know, I mean, there wasn't much going on, or at least that we were in touch with or perceived that was any big deal. We lived in L.A. and lived in kind of middle upper class homes, and you know, went to fairly nice schools. And as far as we knew, the whole object was to have a good time, period.
When I go to sleep, I never count sheep. I count all the charms
about.
Lately it seems, in all of my dreams, I walk with my arms about Linda. But what good does it do me, 'cause Linda doesn't know I exist. I can't help feeling gloomy, thinking about the loving I've missed.
Pass on the street.
My heart skips a beat. I say to myself,
hello,
Linda. If only she'd smile. I'd stop her a while. And then I would get to know Linda. But miracles still happen, and when my lucky star begins to shine. Linda. But miracles still happen, and when my lucky star begins to shine, with one lucky break, I'll make Linda.
Solid Gold Scrapbook.
Two girls for every boy.
I bought a 34 wagon and we call it a Woody.
Surf City, here we come.
You know it's not very cheery, it's an oldie but a goodie.
Surf City, here we come.
Well, it ain't got a backseat or a rear window, but it still gets me where I want.
By Jan with the Brian Wilson of the Beach Boys, their biggest hit, Jan and Dean's Surf City, a number one from 1963. And we'll continue our birthday salute to Dean Torrence of Jan and Dean after a timeout for these messages. And we're back. Though we never got label credit, Dean Torrence sang lead on the Beach Boys smash hit recording of Barbara Ann, and here's how it happened. Dean decided to take a break from a Jan and Dean recording session one night.
We were working on a couple songs that night, and I just said, I'll take a little hiatus and go down to the Beach Boys studio for a couple of hours while Jan would work on this song that I didn't particularly care about. So I went down to the Beach Boys studio, and they were doing songs from a certain, like, 50s era at the time, and I don't know how, you know, I was asked, what do you want to do? And I said, well, what type of tunes have you done in the last hour or so? And they kind of, you know, come go with me in some of those old doo-wop tunes, and I said, I know a great tune that we could all do together that would fit. And I said, what about Barbara Ann?
Barbara Ann went to a dance looking for romance. saw a barber in, so I thought I'd take a chance with barber in.
From 1963, Drag City, Jan and Dean in the Scrapbook, another tune that Jan Barry and Brian Wilson worked on together. The Beach Boys and Jan and Dean, the two groups are inextricably linked. They had a lot in common after all. L.A., a preoccupation with the surfing scene and cars, and they appeared on one another's records.
Since still L.A. was in the infancy stage of being involved in the music business, again, people left us alone, and we were able to get together even though if we were like New York, I'm sure that our companies would have made sure that we didn't get together and share, because that wasn't really the way music was done at the time. If you were on separate labels, you were to stay away from one another and not help, you know, contribute anything to anybody else's career. And again, by the time they caught us, it was too late. And we had figured out ways to getting around all that stuff. So we were using the same studios. We had records out maybe 2 years before they did. They were very much influenced by some of the things that we did. And when we heard their records, we were very much influenced by some of the things they were doing.
Queen of the Surfer Girl.
Big favorite of mine, Honolulu Lulu, Jan and Dean on Solid Gold Scrapbook. Darn if the hits didn't start piling up for Jan and Dean on the Liberty label. Pretty soon it was surfing, girls, cars, girls, surfing, and cars.
Started to swerve, and then I saw the Jag slide into the curve. I know I'll never forget that horrible sight. I guess I found out for myself that everyone was right.
Unforgettable, 1964, Dead Man's Curve, Jan and Dean, a song that would prove tragically, strangely prophetic for the group. Dead Man's Curve, I'm Dick Bartley, and Solid Gold Scrapbook will continue in a moment.
Du rande rande, du rande rande, du rande rande.
I got a bad for the new girl in school. The guys are flipping, but I'm playing it cool. Everybody's passing notes in class. They really dig her, now she's such a gas. Chicks are jealous of the new girl.
The chicks are jealous of the new girl.
They put her down and they treat her so
well. They put her down and they treat her so well.
The guys are going out of their mind.
But
she's the finest chick you'll ever find.
She's the new girl in school.
Du rande rande, du rande rande, du rande rande. Till she transferred here.
Got It Bad for the New Girl in School, originally meant to be called When Summer Comes, Gonna Hustle You, Jan and Dean from 1964. There was always something about Jan and Dean records, goofy, light, crazy. What made the songs hits then and continues to attract audiences today? Dean Torrence remembers.
A sense of humor and kind of a non-pretentiousness about, you know, what we do. And I think that young people, all in all, really do appreciate that, and they can sense that a lot quicker than most. As an adult, you know, I'm always trying to read into things, you know, a little bit too much. You know, young people just take it for what it is. So humor is very, very important. I mean, the songs are humorous, for God's sake, you know. So we're not going to treat them, you know, with much reverence. This is rock and roll, you know. So what if they happen to be hits? That's all very well and nice, but they are basically rock and roll.
It's the little old lady from Pasadena.
The little old lady from Pasadena.
Go, Granny, go, Granny, go, Granny, go.
Has a pretty little flower bed of white gardenias.
Go, Granny, go, Granny, go, Granny, go.
But parked in a rickety old
shiny red super stock top.
And everybody's saying that there's nobody meaner than the little old lady from Pasadena.
She drives me fast and she drives me fast.
She's the terror of Colorado Boulevard.
It's the little old lady from Pasadena.
If you see her on the street, don't try to choose her.
She was a character. I mean, she really was a character. Charming little old lady, Catherine Milner, and she was in her, late 80s, and she did minor acting parts and things, playing her character, and somehow she became involved in some commercials for Dodge. And they had this commercial where she was driving a hot rod, super stock Dodge that had, you know, headers and a supercharger and all that stuff. And she would always end up blowing some young kids off in a race or whatever, or ditching a cop or something. And at the end of the commercial, she'd come screeching to a halt right in front of the camera, turn, look in the camera, and say, "Put a Dodge in your garage, honey."
Next for Jan and Dean was the title theme from the Fabian movie Ride the Wild Surf in 64.
In Hawaii, there's a place known as Waimea Bay, where the best surfers in the world come to stay. And ride the wild surf, they come to try to conquer those waves some 30 feet high.
Jan and Dean in the scrapbook. This one's got to be close to a record for length of title. I don't know how they got it all on the label, to tell you the truth. Let me read it to make sure I got it. The Anaheim, Azusa, and Cucamonga Sewing Circle Book Review and Timing Association.
For the Anaheim, Azusa, and Cucamonga Sewing Circle Book Review and Timing Association.
They wear burgundy dresses and high button shoes. They read Playboy magazine and hot rod news. There's patience proper and prudence prim. You ought to see them do the swim. The little old ladies waiting while anticipation for the meetings of the AACASSN.
For the Anaheim, Azusa, and Cucamonga Sewing Circle Book Review and Timing Association.
They tool around town in their big Grand Prix, sitting in their bucket seats, shooting the breeze. You know that all week long they put up jam and preserves, but on the weekend they negotiate curves.
For the
Susa and Cucamonga Sonic Circle Book Review and Timing Association.
Breaks up with a thunderous roar, then there's a mad, mad rush for the big oak door. They run to their cars like the start at Le Mans, then they go spinning donuts in their lawns. The little old ladies waiting while anticipation for the meetings of the AACASSN.
For the Anaheim, Azusa, and Cucamonga Sewing Circle Book Review and Timing Association. For the Anaheim, Azusa, and Cucamonga Sewing Circle Book Review and Timing Association.
I forgot to sing Incorporated on the end. Jan and Dean. I'm Dick Martley. It's a birthday salute to Dean Torrence of Jan and Dean fame on Solid Gold Scrapbook, and I'll be right back.
Look.
Solid Gold Scrapbook.
We've been going steady now for such a long time. And up until now, everything was just fine.
Jan and Dean collector's item, You Really Know How to Hurt a Guy on Solid Gold Scrapbook. Next up, Sidewalk Surfin' by Jan and Dean, a tune that began as Catch a Wave by the Beach Boys. But Jan and Dean wanted to put different words to it, as Dean remembers.
Yeah, we had always liked that tune. It was a great tune, and pretty nice arrangement, too, as well. The Beach Boys did not spend a whole lot of time on that tune when they did it, because they considered it just an album filler. Some maybe 2 years down the road, when we were looking for a tune to use with a skateboard idea that we had, somehow that just fit it. It just that particular tune worked out very well for some of the words that we had already written. And we called up Brian and asked him if we needed his approval to change the tune, and a matter of fact, he even asked for his help. And as I remember, he did help in rewriting it. And then Jan, you know, made some new arrangement twists to it, and Sidewalk Surfing was born. So it was really a hybrid.
Grab your board and go sidewalk surfing with me.
Okay.
skate right on through. Why don't you grab your board and go sidewalk surfing with me?
Grab your board, let's go sidewalk surfing with Jan and Dean on the Pop Music Almanac, Solid Gold Scrapbook. I'm Dick Bartley. If you followed the news reports at the time or saw the 1978 TV movie about the career and lives of Jan and Dean, you know that Jan Barry was critically injured in an automobile accident back in 1966. His recovery continues today. With Jan in such critical condition, a continuation of the duo's recording career was impossible in the 1960s. Only twice more would Jan and Dean find the top 30. I Found a Girl was one of those records, written by Sloan and Barry. Sounds more like a Turtles record than one by Jan and Dean.
I found a girl. Anybody can see just by looking at me, but I found a girl.
I found the stars
that never shine are shining tonight. I'm feeling groovy.
That is a good old rock and roll top 40 hit record, I Found a Girl. One more Jan and Dean nugget is on the way from the pages of the Pop Music Almanac.
That popsicle man.
Orange, lemon, cherry, and lime. Fudge, tutti frutti, and a grape that's fine.
Buy one
for me and one for my chick.
A lot of good eating. sitting on a popsicle stick.
Popsicle.
But if you wanna keep cool, it does a trick. And it comes on a stick. Some people buy popsicles just for kicks. Like me and my baby, we save the sticks to keep brother and sisters quiet as a mouse. We give them popsicle sticks to build a popsicle house. It comes on a stick. This record on
Jan and Dean Popsicle in the Pop Music Almanac. Happy birthday, Dean Torrence, and thanks to you and Jan for all the fun music over the years.